Hey guys, Shadow Poofy here. I'm back. Female Mike is back to play Five Nights at Freddy's 3. Yes. I'm ready for this. Are you guys ready for this? Alright. Oh gosh. I remember this place. Not ready to play with you, Springtrap.
Hi.
No. Yes. Yay. The female Mike survived yet another. Crud, it's a mini game. Yes! That's another character of mine. Mangle. It's not my... It's Scott's character since he created it, but I would be Mangle if I was an animatronic. Yay! Exit, right? Nope! Not at all. Oh, I have a second night! Great! That's wonderful. That's just great. Oh, fluff.
Hey man, okay, I have some awesome news for you. First of all, we found some vintage audio training cassettes. Dude, these are like prehistoric. I think they were like training tapes for like other employees or something like that. So I thought we could like have them playing like over the speakers as people walk through the attraction. Dude, that makes this feel legit, man.
around to operate these suits as accidents, slash injuries, slash death, slash irreparable and grotesque maiming can occur. We will discuss how to operate the mascots when they are in animatronic form. For ease of operation, the animatronics are set to turn and walk towards sound cues. This is an easy and hands-free approach to making sure the animatronics stay where the children are for maximum entertainment slash crowd-pleasing value. To change the animatronics to suit mode, insert and turn firmly the hand crank provided by the manufacturer. Turning the crank will recoil and compress the animatronics around the sides of the suit, providing room to climb inside. Make sure the spring locks are fastened tight to ensure the animatronic devices remain safe. We will cover this in more detail in tomorrow's session. Remember to smile. You are the face of Freddy Fazbear's Pizza.
That was female Mike playing FNAF 3. No. Spring Trap just wanted a hug. Well, see you later. Till FNAF 4. Bye, fellow FNAFers. And humans. Same place.